the odd and bizarre stories. Jay gets in, stirs it up, and spits it out. He's a professional. It's all here on the Jay Thomas Show with Rodney Lee Conover, Julie Madison, Kevin Meaney, Garrett and Christina, and Ira the Weatherman. This is the Jay Thomas Show.
It is. 888-4102-102. That's the number to call to get in. Kevin Meaney is here. Kevin, we haven't had you on in weeks for some.
Yeah, I know, Jay. It's been a while, but I'm glad to be back. I was I was sick. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was very
really
sick. Yeah. I was in the hospital mental institution for a couple of weeks.
I see. And you're back out now?
Lost it, yeah, and
well, I'm not the guy to call when you're in real trouble. I think have people told you that?
Oh, yeah. They said, stay away from Jay. He won't help you. And I said, that's good.
No, I'm not the guy to call. I'm okay, like, the first rush in and help, you know, to get a lot of adulation the first day or two. And then I tend to disappear.
Right.
You know? What I like to do is be given chores and like let's say someone's sick or mentally ill is also good or someone's attempted suicide or whatever. Mm-hmm. I come in and everyone's all upset. I go, look, tell me what you need done and I'll go do it. And then I leave and come back many hours later, you know, many hours later. So,
well, I'm good. Everything is good. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm back up to speed.
You sound a little, down in the throat.
Really? Well, I've been working too. You know.
Okay.
You know,
good.
I've been. You know, I was
good.
I was out in Scranton.
How was that?
Scranton, Pennsylvania. That was something else. I tell you, they love me out in Scranton.
Now, when you say they love you, I think would you move to Scranton? I mean, what mm-hmm. what's the town look like? What's it?
I saw it at night. So at night, they had a lot of lights, and there was a Clarion Hotel that I did my performance in.
Uh huh.
And above the little platform that I was on, there was a cardboard sign that said Wisecrackers.
So you
and there
entered...
were some pictures up of Jonathan Winters.
Wow.
There was a Steve Allen photo.
How long ago was Jonathan Winters at?
No, just random photos of comedians, you know, to let them know it was a comedy club.
But under this hand-drawn cardboard sign.
Yes.
Why don't they have, like, a local Scranton sign maker, you know, put up
I think they just dig coal there. I think it's a coal mining town.
See, my image of it is, and, you know, and I've never been to Scranton, is I envision, like, the Deer Hunter. I don't know what town the Deer Hunter was in. It was in Pennsylvania, where Scranton is. I don't know what town it was in, but you pull into town... And your car has the salt and the residue of the snow and everything.
Yeah, and there was 3 feet of snow there.
And you're looking out of your if we're doing a film, you're looking out of your dirty window that has all the snow and soot and everything on it.
Yeah.
And you look down on Scranton and you see a smokestack, maybe no smoke coming out of it. Some cars, you see some sort of a factory, maybe a football stadium and a rundown high school, and then we cut to the center of town, and you are, you know, chugging along, and it's a diner, and it's maybe a little hotel, and but that's the old days. Is that what Scranton looks like now?
Well, there was no smokestacks, because there's no more coal left. They
took the smokestacks down.
The smokestacks are down. So there was a couple of 7-Elevens. There were some terrorist groups walking around going, ay, 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 ay.
There were Muslims in Scranton.
Yeah.
Now, that's odd to me. What would the Muslims be doing in Scranton?
They just come to see my show.
I see.
Yeah.
So you had some Muslims at the show.
Yeah, and I love them. They pay extra.
It sounds like to me that you go places where people need a laugh.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, where they need a laugh.
I'm good with a captive audience.
Well, sure.
Like a prison, hospital, the senior shows that I do, I start up again on those next week. So I'm looking forward to doing that.
What prison have you done?
What prison haven't I done?
You've actually done prison.
Oh, yeah. The state pays for them.
Where you go in and you tell jokes to people that are incarcerated from everything from...
And I wear my bow tie on those gigs. You know, real happy. I'm crazy. No, I don't do prisons. I don't do prisons.
You don't do a prison.
No.
All right.
I would, though. I would do a prison.
No, I know you would, and they'd be so appreciative.
If they paid me, I would do it, yeah.
I wonder if there's a prison, kind of a circuit you could do, kind of a state prison circuit.
Well, you know, I go on my first cruise at the end of the month.
Now, that's good work, because I haven't been offered a cruise in years, but when I was offered cruises, I was told you only work 3 nights a week, and you only work for like 30 minutes each night or something. Is that true?
That is true. I finished my soup, by the way.
That's all done.
Okay.
That's good.
I'm done now.
I like that it's 3 o'clock back in New York, and no one apparently has eaten anything all day.
Well,
they find it necessary to come into the cafeteria show, mm-hmm. as I like to call it. Jesus, don't eat at work, and don't blow your... What is the matter with you?
Blow my nose.
Yeah. Before the show is over, we will have, our guest, as we always have, Mason. It's got a T in it, but it's T-V-E-R-T, Tvert. Is it a silent T, Garrett Andritz, the producer of the show?
Trevette. No, I think it's Tvert.
Tvert, but yeah. You're guessing.
No, we've had him on the show before.
Now, he's coming on because he says marijuana is safer than booze, and he wants MTV especially to stop showing people drinking. Mason, what was Mason on before? Something about marijuana?
Something about in Denver, Colorado.
He's a heavyset fella, isn't he? Yeah.
Oh, is he the guy that has the restaurant and he serves the marijuana brownies and all that?
No, that's a different guy.
That'll be a different guy. Yeah, somebody else.
Did Shuley ever go out to, write the reviews on the marijuana bars?
Boy, you know what? He did not.
He didn't.
He didn't. You know, his wife is having a baby tomorrow.
Yeah, having my baby.
Yeah, so
what
once that...
What a lovely time to change my name and number.
Since that happened...
I heard your interview with Kevin Bacon. That was fantastic. What happened to them? Oh, no.
Like Alec Baldwin, if you were to mention his daughter or the fact that over the holidays, which is amazing to me... I mean, they're saying alleged, but apparently he supposedly threatened, said, I'm going to take pills or whatever, and he was put in the hospital and then let out later, but they have a 911 call and people verified it. He's still going to be the MC of the Academy Awards.
Yeah.
Oscars. He is doing the thing on AMC or the Turner Movie Classics.
And he's on the Marriage Ref with...
On the Marriage Ref, and he's about to open in a play out there somewhere. And so you would think that would be too much pressure for a guy who sounds like he's under pressure, But no, and they just, keep rolling along. I feel
badly. What about Charlie Sheen? I mean, this guy gets away with murder, Charlie Sheen. Now
he's
in rehab.
2 weeks of rehab is all he has to do, and he's back on the show. I feel badly about the Kevin Bacon interview, and I was speaking.
You shouldn't feel badly. He should feel bad, and he should call the show and say, "Listen, why did I react that way? I reacted because I was mad that I lost money." He was like mad at you that you brought it up. Like, ooh, like everybody wants to. Of course, you want to hear about Bernie Madoff, how you made a deal with Bernie.
Well, I'm a strange guy, and since I'm so insecure, I always feel as though that I probably made the mistake.
No.
And if my wife were to listen to the interview or my kids, they would agree that I screwed up and I attacked the man and all this other stuff. Mm-hmm. I spoke to a vice president today from Sirius XM, and they're listening to it very carefully. because apparently Kevin Bacon's people...
He's pulling all his music from Sirius.
Yeah.
yeah.
Like Michael Jackson did years ago when I was at...
all the music is coming off the air. No Amos more Broadcast. Bacon Brothers.
Yeah.
He was supposed to be in the glass cube, and he's not doing it now.
Well, you're right. He feels as though that he was ambushed
by
that question.
Are you fucking serious?
Now, are you the same way as I am? Because our careers, and you're brilliant, and I'm very good also, and all that stuff, but, we're stuck in some sort of, middle kind
of... I was in Scranton last Saturday.
Nether.
Things are taking off for me.
Right.
It was in Denver the week before.
That's good. Denver sounds better than Scranton.
Yeah. But
we're Mohegan in another
Sun.
That's good, too. The
yeah.
Nether, the Nether
the
area. But as soon as he comes on, or right before it, I'm already insecure and jealous and everything else. And I said this to the vice president today. I said, tell him that I'm jealous. Now, the vice president said something interesting
he
to me.
He called the vice president of Sirius, Kevin Bacon?
No, his handler's
team. His handler.
Now, wait a second.
Because of this program.
Well, here's another problem. Normally, actors come on here, and they will know a little bit about me from sitcoms or whatever, and they will throw me a little bone, a little ego bone, and they'll bring up something stupid. They'll say Mork and Mindy or Cheers or whatever, or a movie or whatever, or a TV show. They'll throw this guy, and Garrett backed me up on this, apparently had no idea.
No
that
clue.
I'd ever acted or anything.
Yeah. Were you ever in any movie with him? Or
no, but I know so many people he knows and have been in that group. And I was talking to a director that I know really well that actually worked with him and stuff. I don't want to say any names right now. But
why wouldn't you want to say any names? I mean, why? What kind of trouble do you think you're going to get?
No trouble.
This is ridiculous.
So I realized that as we're talking that I'm a pageant for the needy in whatever town that is.
I don't want his money now.
Really?
He just annoyed.
Where were you when you heard
I was in the car. I was driving up to my home in Forestburg, New York. I have a beautiful
What did you think
there,
of the silences?
Acres.
That seems to be the biggest problem.
Yeah, the silence was great. It was so great. It's so personal. Listening to your show, I've enjoyed it so much. There's nobody that makes me laugh harder than Ira. When Ira comes on and says,
did you hear that? I thought he was going to say me. Okay.
What's the temperature in Denver? 62 degrees. I laugh out loud. And nothing is said. You know, you never say anything about it. And he just like, you know, random temperatures. That's
what
it.
Do people love about him? I don't know what they love.
It's the great voice, you know. It's like he doesn't have any idea what temperature it really is. And he's just saying it's 26 degrees. And then you laugh. I just laugh.
But he also tells you if in fact that is the temperature, what you know already. He doesn't do a future, like a forecast.
Yeah, no.
You know, let's go to
the Seven Seas.
Yeah, that's
and of course the Seven Seas Diner.
And what's the baby Eleanor, the little baby? Now here's the great thing about him: you remember everything he says because he says them so many different times. I mean, but he says them in the same way, and he'd be a great advertiser, you know, for people.
Yeah.
Tony of Wisconsin, always exciting when Kevin Meaney has come on the show. He's finished his soup. He's had a complete 4-course meal, and now he's ready to perform.
I'm bulked up.
Tony, Wisconsin, the Jay Thomas Show. How are you, Tony?
Jay, how you doing?
Good. Before we go any further, weren't there some Americans on our curling squad for the Olympics that were from Wisconsin? Am I correct about that, Tony?
Tony,
put him back on. Hit the button there.
Is that...
Hit 4. Tony, I'm sorry. I don't know what you're thinking. Tony, were there some American curlers on our great Olympic team?
I didn't watch the curling part of it. I was just trying to catch the hockey part of it.
Right, I see that. But I believe we had some... One of the curlers has already taken her clothes off
magazine.
Not ours.
But nice. Nice.
Yeah. That's what they're saying, already naked. It's the most exciting sport ever. So,
that
Tony,
What
did you call us about? Kevin Meaney is here today. Of course, it is the Jay Thomas Show. And, yes, sir, go ahead, Kevin.
Jay's the main host.
Tony. I'm the main host.
Kevin.
Go ahead, Tony.
I was just calling. I heard the Kevin Bacon interview, and it's like you made it pretty clear. His people didn't tell you you can't talk about this. You were asking this question. You conducted a very good interview, and he just blew it a bunch. I think you did a great job. Fuck him.
Yeah.
Well, the other thing that happened is Rodney Lee Conover was very uncomfortable.
And I know he was. I know.
Yeah, but then he, like, and later on he was like, oh, I defended you, and I told you it was great.
You don't know impregnated you. or you don't want the kid or whatever. It's not killing black kids. Oh, there's no sign up like that.
What about your baby? What about your son?
I gave him up for adoption.
But you gave the, and now you have a relationship with him. If she would have aborted the baby, you wouldn't have that kid now.
I also, two women I was with had abortions, and I have a relationship with those blood clots.
Ugh.
I actually do.
Oh, God.
There's Nigel.
Nigel Clot.
And Tina.
Tina Clot.
Yeah, both of them. Andrew, thanks for listening. They ought to be putting pictures of Chinese up in China and stopping all that. Stay where you are. He thinks that more marijuana needs to be smoked by kids and stop that drinking. All right, stay where you are.
Oh, yeah.
Come here, Tina. Come on, sweetheart.
Nigel.
Nigel, where are you, sweetheart? Okay, climb onto your Petri dish. All right.
It's 76 degrees.
Listen to The Pulse to discover pulsating new music for the first time.
We found these artists first.
Zara Bareilles. The Script.
Colby Calais.
Be the next new artist you discover.
Listen to find out as we mix in the 2000s with today.
Sirius 12.
The Pulse. Fridays at 8 p.m. East.
The Game On guys give you the tips and tricks to bag the girl.
Yo, guys, Jordan Harbinger here from Game On and the Art of Charm. It's always better to exchange than to receive, especially when we're talking about phone numbers. When you're getting a girl's phone number, it's always a good idea to make sure she puts your number in her phone at the same time. This way, if a stretch of time goes by between texts, you don't get that dreaded, who is this text, right? Also, most girls, especially girls that talk to a lot of guys, they don't answer calls from unknown numbers. When you're saved in her phone, now you belong to a group of people such like her friends, family, and coworkers who are a regular part of her life, and this helps ensure that she'll pick up or reply next time you try to get in touch. After you get the digits, don't just bounce, but continue the conversation for a little while. This accomplishes a few things. When you call, she'll be much more likely to answer, and you won't need to put as much effort into maintaining attraction until you meet up next. And last but not least, you solidify the connection and the attraction that you're building with her. This is huge. If you're currently getting a lot of phone numbers, but they end up flaking or not calling you back, this is probably a big reason why. It's because you bounce right after you get the digits. If you guys want to learn some more about getting phone numbers and getting a date, check out AJandJordanTalkChicks.com, and we will definitely school you. Be sure to catch us on Game On every Friday at 8 p.m. Eastern on Sirius 108 XM 139.
TheArtOfCharm.com.
For more ways to live a great life.
And get the girl. Only on Stars 2.
Stars 2.
Sirius 108 and XM 139.
Blurriness, wavy lines, blind spot.
These are all symptoms of a chronic condition called wet age-related macular degeneration, or wet AMD. It can develop quickly, and it's a leading cause of blindness in people 60 and older. March is AMD Awareness Month. Visit AMDAwareness.org to learn about your risk factors and how a retina specialist can help. Knowing the symptoms may save your sight. Learn what you need to know at AMDAwareness.org today. This message brought to you by the American Society of Retina Specialists and Genentech.
Overwhelmed with credit card debt? President Obama recently signed the stimulus plan to re-energize our troubled economy. But where was the bailout for the general public struggling with credit card debt? Fortunately, if you owe $10,000 or more to credit card companies, help is available. Call Consumer Debt Advocate for assistance and free information. The toll-free number is 1-800-992-7567. If you have debt of $10,000 or more, you may begin calling now. Debt assistance is available for members of the public in serious need of debt relief. The information is free, courtesy of Consumer Debt Advocate. The toll-free number to call is 1-800-992-7567. Our debt relief consultants have already advised thousands of people just like you. You could save thousands of dollars. Listeners with debt of $10,000 or more needing credit card relief are urged to call immediately for this free information. This is a confidential call. The toll-free number is 1-800-992-7567. Again, 1-800-992-7567.
As your car gets older, it will have mechanical problems. If your factory warranty has expired, an extended vehicle protection plan can save you thousands by paying all your covered repairs. At A-Plus Auto Protection, we work with BBB-rated providers to offer you a full menu of coverage options. We do the comparison shopping for you, so you save money with our discounts. For a limited time, also get roadside assistance and towing, but you must call now. 800-567-9901. 800-567-9901. Metal plastic bubble for all vehicles.
The Jay Thomas Show.
Jay Thomas.
Stars 2.
The curious. The extreme. The fascinating.
The fascinating.
Jay Thomas. On Stars 2. Sirius 108 XM 139. And on the Sirius XM iPhone and BlackBerry app.
A little while ago, Kevin Meaney was saying how generous Hillary Clinton was being. She was in Argentina laughing with the female president of Argentina. She's a very sharp woman, I might add. Giggling and laughing, probably making jokes about men. And then she flew on to Chile, where she brought 20 satellite phones with her. And the city of Concepcion, which has over 200,000 people in it, maybe not that many anymore. The 20 phones, what's 20 into 200,000? What is that?
0.1%?
No, how many people per phone?
0.1?
No, 10,000.
Ratio. Okay.
There's one phone for every 10,000 people.
Yeah.
Well, thanks, Hillary. That's a brilliant idea. How long do you think it's going to take them to hand that phone around? And then you have to use a calling card. And, you know, it's something like $20 a minute on a satellite phone. Who's going to pay for that? Who's going to use that phone?
Hillary.
Nobody. What they ought to do is set up cameras like, you know, Skype or whatever, and just put them all over the city and let people stand in front of the camera and go, "Look, it's me, I'm safe," like that. Not 20 friggin' satellite phones. What good is that?
I just heard that don't shoot the messenger. I thought that was a really nice thing to bring to Chile. Some communications.
I guess if New York ever fell down from some tragedy, she'd, you know, because we have, 8, 9 million people, 12 million people, maybe she'd bring as many as 1,000 phones.
Yeah, maybe a few phones. You can set up a phone
center. That's not going to help anyone.
Of course it's going to help. That's a nice thing.
If you wanted to get in touch with your daughter, and you hadn't heard from your daughter, and you saw someone with a satellite phone, you would hit them in the head with something to get to the phone. Right? That's what it's going to cause.
Well, first of all, you got to calm down. You've got to get your medication under control. That's the first
I'm
thing.
Fine.
The first
I'm
thing.
Fine.
No, I'm saying in that situation. I'm not saying you right now.
Oh, right.
I'm saying in that situation, you have to calm down and you have to get your medication under control. That's the first thing you do. And you took it to say that I was attacking you.
Yeah.
That you should.
I'm in a mood today.
I know you are.
I'm in a
crazed.
Mood.
Oh, God.
The Gundersons, LaDonna.
Gunderson.
The Gunderson. The LaDonna and Oli.
LaDonna and Oli Gunderson.
They listen to us as they're salmon fishing in Alaska.
Mm-hmm.
And they've actually sent me fresh, delicious salmon. And they visited me in my studio, believe it or not, my secret studio location. And they, LaDonna has a cooking video, sent it to me. And,
this is her salmon that she cooks?
Yes, and it's right there in the boat. And we should put it on, you know what, Garrett, could you run a little bit of the cooking video for us? Because they're on the boat right now, out in the middle of the Pacific Ocean.
My cookbook is Alaskan Rocking Galley.
Oh.
My favorite way and Oli's favorite way is the spicy salmon sandwiches.
Oh, this is too good.
It's so easy. He loves it for dinner.
Right in the galley.
This is too good.
I'm going to make Oli and I spicy
I hate it that
sandwich.
Everybody can do a TV show. It bothers me.
Jalapenos go in the mayonnaise.
Oh. It makes me sick.
2 tablespoons of brown sugar. 1 1/2
She's got her music. Are these original music?
Of chili powder.
Yeah. Yeah. It's Oli playing.
Yeah, Oli.
Ground cumin.
Human?
Ground human? She put human in there?
Yeah, human. Fingernails. dried Boy Scout cheers.
It started with his mom in a restaurant. I had to learn how to cook in a big hurry.
All right. There's LaDonna listening on the salmon boat, and we'll put that at jthomas.com. God. Put the link to it, and LaDonna's a 2-minute cooking video, or the extended one. There's a 32-minute long one, and the cookbook and everything else.
And she sells this cookbook. I'm going to put out a fucking cookbook.
This video is going to be shown to all the visiting cruise ships in Alaska starting this summer. LaDonna, thank you. I watched the entire thing. Thanks for no mentions. Thanks for no mentions.
You sure you want to put it up on the front page to steal thunder from your Kevin Bacon interview?
Yeah, no, you got to put
the Kevin Bacon interview has been put up on our front page?
Yes, the YouTube links have.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
That's taken off too, isn't it?
It is unseating. It's unseating the interview that you and I did with the man who spent 23 minutes in hell, which was my favorite interview ever.
Oh, I love that.
That's the best interview ever. The man.
Yeah.
And you kept asking him if there were was it gay sex in hell, and did you ask him if Hitler and Saddam Hussein were playing ping pong, or did I ask him?
I don't know.
Someone just did email me at jthomas.com and asked if, in fact, Kevin and I are ever drunk or stoned during the show. We will not answer those kinds of questions. We're going to be just like...
we have to talk to the DEA all the time. Now, earlier, it appeared that I was getting stoned. But that was just an old radio trick,
yes.
You know, that we in the industry do. Of course, I would never do that and go against the rules here at Sirius Satellite Radio.
Now we are not under federal communications auspices.
No, but
we have to live under the state and federal laws, the state of New York, and, of course, the federal laws of the United States government.
And of course, the laws here, or the rules that we have
the
here
rules.
At Sirius.
Yes.
You know?
So that's it. And I would never actually drink anything on the air.
In the equity contract of the actors,
professional actors,
I'm sure you're part of equity because you've done theater work, stage. You are in the rule book. Mm-hmm. You are allowed to consume alcohol before you go on stage. There's no ruling.
Why would they say that?
There is no rule saying that you cannot, have a drink, because alcohol is very important to a stage actor.
I've never in my life...
It always has been.
...thought that that would be a rule. Did that come from, the Irish actors?
How dare you?
That's the truth.
Well, there was Peter O'Toole, Richard Burton would like to have a drink before the show.
If you work with an actor, and maybe they're not drunk, but you could smell the booze in their breath, that scares me more than anything in the world. Is when you walk on a stage and you can smell that.
Yes, I did. That, I did
that
work with
that sweet breath of alcohol. Yeah.
But you know who it was? It was Harry Carey. So
the announcer
for the Cubs, and we were actually at Wrigley Field, and we were shooting Uncle Buck there, and he was in the we were in the booth. And Uncle Buck was calling a game with Harry Carey or something like that, and I went in there and he was drunk as could be, and they called me one take Harry. I was like, oh, you're the greatest, and this is where I pee, and he had a pee can right underneath him, and it was great. One take Harry, they called me.
Mike in Cleveland says, Kevin seems to have a lot of gigs in Pennsylvania. Kevin, do you have a big Amish following?
Yes, I do, yeah. I travel by foot. That's why.
Yes.
And I go from town to town letting everyone know on my journeys that where I'll be making, I'll be going to the next town to make them.
They're not allowed to go to your thing, are they? They're not allowed.
That's why I go to them.
Okay. By the way, Mike of Cleveland, according to Forbes.com, Cleveland has been named the country's most miserable city, based on the city's unemployment, taxes, weather, pollution, and other criteria. Believe it or not, I'm sure Detroit was second, but it bypassed Detroit. So I don't
see that. Cleveland is a great town. I mean, I would have to say Detroit was probably the most miserable town I've been in a long time.
Yeah.
And I was out there a couple of times this year. I was there for New Year's Eve. You know, so, you know, the suburbs and everything are really nice. But in the inner city, you know, you'll go by, you have to do media. And the driver will bring you by. He'll go, do you need anything? I can pick you up a bump here or there. No. You'll be driving by. He goes, you know, you could buy that house over there for a dollar.
Right.
The houses
in Detroit,
are for sale here for a dollar. In Detroit.
Detroit.
Houses for a dollar.
They sold the Silver Dome for $500,000+, and it was built for millions and millions of dollars. I mean, it's a huge stadium. They sold it for $500,000.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's absolutely insane. I mean, I don't know why companies don't come in and buy whole cities. Just come in and knock all the friggin' houses down. And of course, yes, get rid of the people. Everyone's always going, what's going to happen to the poor people? They say this in New Orleans all the time, too. And you go, well, I don't know. They'll probably just move to another shitty area. How's that? Just move along. Move along. You know? I think you take the ones that can't walk and the ones that are, you know, really in bad shape and the children. And you weed them out and you take care of them. But the ones that are walking around and are, you know, healthy, and I mean this. There's a woman on the corner, you know, you walk out of the building there, and even in New York, you go, can I have a dollar? And you go, if you can talk like this and you can live out here, then you are a survivor and you're mighty damn healthy.
Okay? Oh, I saw this guy the other day, he had two canes. Two canes, and he was, oh, you got anything for me? Anything? A cup of coffee? And I felt so bad for him. I was with my daughter, and I said, well, let me give him some. So my daughter didn't even see me give him anything, because she went into the store with my friend. So they went, and I gave him a dollar, and thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. Oh, God, thank you.
To buy booze with.
So then I come out of the store with Kate and my friend Henriette, and we walk up the street. Next thing you know, I see the guy dancing up the street with the two canes. Not skipping and dancing. I was like, you gotta be kidding me. This guy was like a genius actor. You know, like just came up to me and like begged his heart out for anything. And I gave it to him, and I really wanted to kill him. After I saw him, I wanted to break his legs. And
absolutely.
And I said, I bet, you know, I can't do that in front of my daughter, you know. You know, give me my money back, you bastard. You bastard.
Yeah, it is weird. It's like, I wonder what percentage of the homeless and the people by the highway and all of this stuff, I wonder what percentage of them are able to work. Now, I know they're nuts.
I wonder who makes the most money. Like, you know, like, there's got to be one guy, like the master of, like, you know, scamming. Where he doesn't, like, you know, listen, you know, most of them are pathetic.
If you have a kid with you. There are ones that have a kid with them. Yeah. Oh, my God. I mean, I just, you know, I don't know what that's. But, you know, you'll see these young guys, and you can tell they're young. You can see it in their eyes. They'll have a beard, and their clothes are dirty, and they're, they've got the sign up, you know. And you want to go, come on, man. What are you, nuts?
Yeah.
What are you? You all, I mean, I don't want to roll a window because they'll punch you. But, you know, they say that if all of the people that said they were Vietnam veterans, that there would have been 2 or 3 million soldiers in Vietnam. That's how many guys say they were veterans, you know. Everyone's a friggin' veteran.
I like it when they have, like, World War I veteran.
No.
Wow. God, you look great.
Do you have the Olympic sound effect, the new one? Do we have the old one or the new one?
Because
crazy stuff happened.
Did you get the red mittens? Did you get those? They were like, everybody
what
has
red
to have
mittens?
That's the big thing from the Olympics this year. Everybody got red mittens.
I don't get red mittens. I watch them
on
TV.
Did you hear about the red mittens?
Yeah,
no.
And Oprah gave them out, too, and it was like
out.
A big deal. Because
weren't
somebody,
they all handmade?
Yeah. And she's like, and you get mittens, and you get mittens.
Yeah, right. Everybody wants those mittens.
Handmade mittens.
Handmade mittens by Canadian, sewing sewers.
The stories are coming out of the Winter Olympics. David Moeller, Germany's silver medalist in the men's singles luge, was shouted at by a photographer and said, take a bite out of your silver medal.
Yeah.
He took a bite out of it, and he broke his tooth in half.
Of course you'd break your tooth in half. Thank God he had that silver to put it back in. They don't use silver anymore. They use plastics.
Norwegian cross-country skier Odd Bojum Heijelmusset said that his bad run that cost him the gold medal was from watching too much porn. He said, I skied. Norwegian? Do you do it? Do you do the voice? I skied. I skied the second lap and fucked up today. I think I've watched too much porn in the last 14 days.
Wow.
Then he said, I have the room next to Peter Northug, and every day I hear noise in there, so I think it's the reason why I fucked up. By the way, he said, Tiger Woods is a really good man. That's the luge guy from...
Are you serious?
He said all this.
Wow.
In Norway. U.S. snowboarder Scotty Lago was sent home before the closing ceremonies.
Yeah.
After they showed a woman kissing his bronze medal down around his waist.
Mm-hmm.
He said he was keeping the medal in a safe spot. And ha ha ha. And I guess the woman was naked, kissing his medal down around.
He's kissing his bronze.
Giving it to him. Further red faces when naked pictures of Germany's Melanie Robillard, she is a curler, she could not get naked fast enough.
A hurler?
Curler. Yes.
Oh, that's a curler, a naked curler.
She's a naked curler, and many of her pictures are up in the ice skating rinks around Germany.
The women of curling.
They're going to take them down.
Yeah.
100,000 condoms were used. It averages out to 14 a person in the Olympic Village, if you can imagine.
Wow.
That's unbelievable. The same thing at the Summer Olympics.
Did they have to turn them in, the used condoms?
No. They 100,000
were used. They were handed out.
100,000
free condoms
were given to 7,000 athletes and officials. And there were none that they saw, like, left over. They didn't have, like...
You know, during World War II, they would give all the soldiers condoms, you know, so they wouldn't get VD from the dirty women.
The saddest one. German speed skater Daniela Anschultz-Toms finished fourth in a major event for the 15th time in 12 years. And her average losing time was 0.03 seconds behind the person that was third. And she said, shit follows me wherever I go. Those that bring up the Olympic music, those are the Olympic
moments. Oh, that's a beautiful. That's the story. That's the movie I want to go see.
There you go.
I want to see
Let's welcome Adam Starr to the Jay Thomas Show. Adam, Kevin Meany is here. Where do you call home, Adam? Where do you live?
I'm in Tempe, Arizona.
Tempe, Arizona.
My son is in Prescott. Doing? And I come to, I've been to Tempe a few times, a lovely, lovely town. And you have a very controversial tree. If you go to facebook.com/P tree, the letter P. So it's shaped like a giant penis, I'm told.
That is correct. Yep. I had a dead tree in my backyard that needed to be cut down, and, had a couple buddies in town from Alaska, and I asked them to cut it down for me, and they cut down most of it and then left a 8-foot carving of a penis.
Are they gay?
No.
No. But they come from Alaska, and they're lonely men.
Well,
do the bushes
in
your backyard look like vaginas? Did they cut those with the holes in the middle and you...
Yeah, I think they're more into carving phallic symbols.
Mm. I see.
Now, was the penis cut?
What's that?
No, it's circumcised.
Is it circumcised?
Oh, yeah.
Can you get him a picture back there in the studio, please, Garrett?
Oh, I got it. Wow, you're a good-looking fella, too.
And you can go to jthomas.com, and we will...
It's a bearded fella with a nice big cock next to him.
Now, Adam, how do you feel about a man who just looked at your picture and a big tree cock next to you, and he finds you attractive? How do you feel about that?
It's a little disturbing, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay. So, well, you take your hat off, I could see your eyes, but...
How do you think I feel? I'm in the studio next to him. Now, it's an 8-foot-tall penis carving, and did your buddies leave you with it and you woke up and saw it, or were they there to enjoy it?
I was at a basketball game. I came back, and it was carved, and then they promptly left town a couple days later and left me with that most of my neighbors got a kick out of it. There was a couple who were a little upset about it.
Yeah.
I read, it says here, one woman said she thought it was disgusting. Did she come in your yard, actually, and ask you to take
Don't
it down?
Don't say, did she come in your yard.
Yeah.
That's disgusting. See, you made it disgusting.
Did she come
like
in
she
your
saw
yard?
The big
and
cock, and she came over and started playing with herself and vagina juice all over the backyard.
Not one neighbor came to my door and complained about my cock in my backyard.
Now, it's sticking up over the back fence,
Sticking up, God!
Yep.
Into this. I tell you what, it is a beautiful carving. I mean, these guys are
true
artists.
You're gay. You're just as gay as I am. Wow.
Now, what are you going to do with the... Is it still up there?
I want it
in
my ass.
I had to cut it down.
Oh, you cut it down.
Yeah, the city of Tempe was going to fine me for having a dead tree in my backyard, so I ended up cutting it down last week.
Was it really because it was a dead tree or because it was carved like a penis?
Well, I think it was because it was carved like a penis, so that's how Tempe worded the violation notice.
What idiots.
Yeah,
did the local newscasters come out there to see it?
Oh, I had 4 different stations come and cover it and do little stories on it, and they all found it funny.
Yeah. Garrett, I want to hear how the stations handled it. I love small town television.
Yeah, right.
I know. Do we have them talking, Garrett?
Yeah.
We're going to listen to the local newscaster there in Phoenix.
Okay.
Tempe Man is making the best of a practical joke, and we want to warn you that the topic of this story may be inappropriate or offensive for some viewers. Usher them out of the room right now. ABC 15's Jody Heisner has this story she filed from Tempe.
That's disgusting. I think it's funny.
If you have nerves enough, I'd like you to take a picture of it and put it on TV so everybody in the valley can see it.
It's the talk of the neighborhood, and you can see why. An 8-foot penis, not erected, but carved out of a tree. Artistic expression? Perhaps a fertility statue? Nope.
Just kind of a practical joke my friends played on me.
This piece of wood was once a pine tree Adam Starr needed cut down. He asked some friends to help him out. But mix alcohol and a couple of guys in chainsaws and...
I came back and they left me a little surprise.
Or a big surprise.
Yeah, I came home and it was actually night and they had had a light fixed on it, shining.
Adam planned on cutting down the tree last weekend, but...
My house got broken into, so I've been kind of busy with other things.
He had no idea his friend's phallic joke would get such a reaction.
Pretty funny that the news is covering a story like this.
But it's gotten the neighbors quite aroused.
Looks like a penis.
Wow. If it was next door to the mayor's house or the police chief's house, one of the city council members, it would be gone.
I love how the microphones they use. And we went to Adam's house, and there was a big, big penis. I mean, Jesus, can't they buy some goddamn equipment? Now, Adam, was she cute, the woman they sent out there to do the report?
Yeah, she was very cute.
You got a date with her?
No, she had a giant rock on her finger, so...
Yeah.
Did any of the gays come out to see the big penis?
Possibly. I had all sorts of people driving by the house taking pictures.
Yeah.
You know what I heard? I heard there's a gay skydiving group that was going to, like, launch over the weekend.
I heard that, too.
Try and see where they can land.
Right.
You know, right up. Now, you cut it from the base, so have you hidden the penis in a bush? Where do you have it right now?
It's just laying down in my backyard. I put it up on eBay, and the first day that I had it up on eBay, I had 25 bids. It was up to about $75, and then eBay removed it.
Oh, come on.
They said I couldn't have a male phallic symbol displayed on eBay.
That is ridiculous.
Why don't you just put it up and just say it's a log?
Yeah, well, man, I was going to do that, but in their email to me, they specifically said any links to pictures or anything, it'll be removed again.
Mm. Why don't you just say it's a tapered turd?
Or a carved mushroom?
Yes, yeah. A giant mushroom.
Yeah, mushroom right. log.
Now, how can we help you sell it? You want me to give the Twitter account or the Facebook? What do you want to do?
Yeah, I mean, I guess if anybody is interested, I was going to donate the money to a charity, and I guess they could contact me through that Facebook page or Twitter.
If you want an 8-foot beautiful penis.
That was carved by two masculine Alaskan mm-hmm. men.
Right.
Could we get pictures of them, you know, of the men that carved it from Alaska? Could that go with the...
Twitter.com, go to Penis Tree on
Twitter. The penis log?
Facebook.com. /Petrie. Yes?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
By the way, can you tell Adam that my buddy Kevin here has no interest in the gals?
He hasn't been asking me a lot about the Alaskans. He cut it down.
Yeah. He'd like to. Now, are they back in Alaska now?
Yep, they're back in Alaska.
All right. Yeah, I wonder what they're doing now up there in the cold.
Yeah, well, one of them's out on a boat fishing right now.
Mm.
Probably trying to get a salmon up his ass. You ever heard a radio show like this, Adam?
Oh, yeah. I listen to you guys.
Really? All right. Adam Starr with two R's, Twitter.com, Penis Tree, or Facebook.com, Petrie, the 8-foot carved penis in his backyard. Thank you, Adam, very much.
And I can cut it down to any size they want.
I'm sure you can.
Yes, you can. All right. Thank you, Adam.
All right. Thanks, Adam.
Yeah. A man who has more wood than you've ever seen in your life.
Hey-o.
There you go. You got it. Kevin's here, and I'm, of course, your main announcer.
Jay Thomas Show. Every day, something new. Something bizarre. For you, for now. The Afternoon Drive Show on Stars 2. Sirius 108, XM 139. And on the Sirius XM iPhone and BlackBerry app. Stars 2. This is Me and Vinny. The morning show on Stars 2. Me and Vinny.
Hey, it's Michael Billy. All football season long, I pick the winners for you in my gay fantasy football segment. Now, the Oscar season is coming up. The tables are turning. Vinny Politan will be picking the Oscar winners for you. On Wednesday, Vinny's going to look at the best supporting actresses.
Me and Vinny. Where the me is you. Me and Vinny. Weekday mornings at 6 a.m. East. The morning show on Stars 2. Sirius 108 and XM 139. Every straight guy needs a gay friend. Michael Billy's not going to change you. Just make you better.
It's time to man up and answer some fan mail. This one comes from Kevin in Alberta, Canada. Kevin writes, "Hey, Michael Billy, my girlfriend likes me to wear my shirts untucked, which I think looks slovenly with anything other than a straight hem and short sleeves. At Thanksgiving, her son had on a sweater vest and a tie, but the shirt was untucked, and I thought it looked sloppy. Am I just out of step with fashion?" Tricky question, Kevin. Don't worry, though. You aren't that out of step with fashion. You can't just wear any dress shirt untucked because some are made to be tucked in. The type of shirt you're looking for is a fitted dress shirt. The way you can tell the difference is that many fitted dress shirts don't have a front pocket, and the bottom of the shirt is cut straight across. Unlike the dress shirt, which has a lot more fabric under the last button, meant for tucking. As for your girlfriend's son, depending upon where you live, the grunge look always works. You never have to model yourself after someone a quarter your age. If you want some fashion ideas, then start looking at guys your age on television. Take what they're wearing and mix and match with your own sense of style. Remember, sexy is all about how confident you feel. So if you don't feel like yourself in an untucked shirt, then don't wear the untucked shirt.
Admit it. That was useful. Get more Michael Billy. Weekday mornings at 6 a.m. East on Me and Vinny. Stars 2, Sirius 108 and XM 139.
Truckers, we know you can't afford to waste time at a weigh station. That's why you need PrePass. With PrePass, highway sensors check your weight and certifications as you drive highway speed. If everything checks, a green light on your dash lets you know you keep on driving. Try it for free. We guarantee you're going to want PrePass along on every haul. Go to PrePass.com and enter the promo code FREE or call 888-599-PASS. That's 888-599-PASS. 888-599-7277.
Shh. Do you hear that? That's right. It's nothing, which is what banks are lending to businesses. You want stimulus money? Good luck. Unless your business is in perfect health, it is not getting a bank loan. If your business sells to other businesses, call Anchor Funding Services. Anchor Funding Services provides immediate cash flow for businesses every day by funding their accounts receivable. For fast cash and a same-day proposal, call 877-70-ANCHOR, 877-70-A-N-C-H-O-R, or go to 70anchor.com.
Jay Thomas. The Jay Thomas Show.
Show.
It's the Afternoon Show.
On Stars 2, Sirius 108, XM 139, and on the Sirius XM iPhone and BlackBerry app.
Carl, Chicago. Thanks for calling the Jay Thomas Show. Kevin Meany's here. Hello, Carl.
I'm just going to give you some information about eBay.
Yeah, what
about? There's a general section where you can sell, you know, a lot of things, but there's also a mature section. And I'm sure that he can sell that item in the mature section.
Oh, you know what, Christina? Get him back on.
I didn't know that there was a mature section on
eBay. Yeah, it's a subsection in there. Yeah, a lot of things. There's like a general area where everyone goes, but then there's a subsection where you have to sign in to get into, but they sell a lot of hardcore stuff there. So,
do you think that Kevin could buy pictures of naked Alaskan men?
Sure, anything.
That's
fair price.
When you say mature, when you click on eBay, does it say mature somewhere?
Yeah, it's under, I'm trying to think, the miscellaneous.
Why wouldn't they have recommended that?
That's
to
what
him?
I was going
to
say.
I have no idea.
Instead, they just threw his ass off of eBay. You know?
Yeah, you go to that section, it'll blow your mind at everything they're selling there. So,
you know, in the state of California, Meg Whitman used to be the president of eBay. She's a billionaire, and she's running for governor.
Really?
And she is meaner than shit. I mean, they're all rough, but she is really rough. And she has threatened to run a campaign that would just, you know, lay waste to people around here. And every time they say she was the former president of eBay, I thought it was a French company at first, wasn't it? Wasn't it started in France?
Jay!
Huh? Adam Starr.
76 degrees.
Carl of Chicago has something to tell you. Carl, talk to Adam Starr, who has the 8-foot carved penis. Go ahead.
Yeah, Adam, there's a subsection in eBay that they strictly sell mature items.
I'm sure
you can put pictures of it up there and sell it in that section.
Yeah, some nice lube up there.
Yeah, I did see that, and I tried that, and but you have to go into that section to do the search, so basically nobody could find it unless they had the actual link.
Gee, and they won't let you link from the general pages over to that section?
Nope. If you do, because I had it posted in the adult section, if you do a search on regular eBay, nothing comes up.
Oh, okay.
Unless you actually log in.
So, Carl, you go, what are some of the things you've seen, Carl?
Put it on Craigslist, men seeking men.
Anything you can type in, I'm sure you can find.
Yeah.
But guys,
Eight-foot wooden penis?
Sure. Giant penis.
Adam, you have to put it in giant wooden penis.
I'm going to do a Google voice search now.
I think pictures
wooden penis. Okay. No, it doesn't. Okay, I have to do it again.
Now,
wooden
Kevin,
penis.
Do you have any friends that could take that thing?
Yes, I do. Okay wooden teeth. It comes up.
That would be perfect for Kevin. Why doesn't Kevin just buy it?
I might buy it.
Put it in the backyard.
Yeah, just put it in your backyard. You know, make a bird feeder out of it or something.
Do you know how many wooden penises I have in my backyard right now?
I think I'm just going to hang on to it and have it in my backyard.
Carl, thank you. Adam Starr, good luck
with
selling the 8-foot penis. Thank you. Wow.
Thanks.
All that came up was wooden teeth.
Wow.
Yeah.
Christine, I need to bring you on the microphone to help me with this next item.
Yes.
Jessica Simpson
is
poor thing.
Absolutely furious at John Mayer.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Because he called her, and I guess, you know, a couple of magazine articles, sexual napalm, and said making love to her was like crack cocaine in his Playboy interview.
Yes.
But he just said she was just unbelievable as a lover. She now is telling this OK magazine that she never thought John would humiliate her like this, and that she has created a monster by introducing Mayer to the world of celebrity dating and making him a tabloid sensation.
Mm-hmm.
Now, here's what I don't get. First of all, let's look at what Jessica Simpson does. She always has her ass completely, like, stuck out.
Right.
Or her tits sticking out or whatever.
Right.
So she's laying around, like, you know, come get on top of me.
Yes.
Put an 8-foot
sex symbol.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Why would she be upset by this?
Well, here's my theory on it. I think that she's secretly not that upset about it. I think that she secretly takes pleasure in the fact that somebody said publicly that she's an animal in bed. But I think that she's fearful of her father because he's a weirdo.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like a preacher kind of, you know, but he's made comments before about her her body, and she was less uncomfortable about her dad making those comments than John Mayer, which I think is strange. But
so you think that she was
molested? I think
she's
got daddy issues.
She may have been molested.
Well, I'm not saying that, but
okay,
I'm
say it. Say something.
But I'm saying that I think part of it is the image that she's worried about with her family, and then also she gets the attention for it because she was known for being the virgin that waited for Nick Lachey, and she was a little
that's
prude,
all crap,
and blah 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 blah.
Wasn't
blah,
she dumber than a goddamn stick when she was on that show?
Oh,
didn't
yeah.
she think Chicken of the Sea was actually
tuna. Yeah.
tuna? It was in the can. It was chicken can. Hold on, one
wasn't
second.
It chicken? Isn't My it chicken?
What do you
it's
want?
It's tuna.
What do you need? I did get the mail.
Is it here?
It is, right? It's in my car.
What is going on there?
What's in there?
This is riveting radio.
This is... Are we on the air?
No, I want my son to come in. Come on over here. You know, people...
And he just broke into the show and just ruined the show.
But
right
you
there.
Can't eat a potato chip.
No, I can't. Yeah, thank you.
No,
thank
no,
you
my
very
son
much.
Is here. There you go. Put those... Okay. There you go. My children, I want to hear my children. This is
the
my...
one you like or the one you say you hate?
No, I like him.
Yeah,
I like you. The one I don't like called a few minutes ago. So that's it.
And then also...
Yeah.
Because I think also now, because she's a little chubby...
What did you order that I picked up for you?
Oh, boy.
What kind of game?
So, Kevin, I think because she's a little chubby...
Yeah.
That may have her...
What sort of game did you get?
Now, what about... let's talk about penises again.
Okay.
You know...
Yeah. I love to talk about
We penis. Had that big
8-foot wooden penis.
In your backyard.
Penis. Yeah. Now, do you think we should send that 8-foot penis to Jay and his family?
Mm-hmm.
No,
yeah.
I'm
going
to
His
show.
Kids would probably get a kick out of that.
I think we should send it to the kid that he put up for adoption.
This kind is just
like
the
a parting.
Of the penis I throw the oh my god! The guy's his buddy's carved an 8-foot penis in the backyard
out of wood.
Out of wood.
Yeah, that's real.
I
wood.
Wish I had someone to talk to.
Kay
Garrett. I wish I could have talked to my daddy about.
Do you
want to
talk about
wooden
penises?
So you thought that the Jessica Simpson thing is because of her dad?
I think a part of it's because of her dad, and I also think that because she's a little chubby right now, she doesn't want people to be imagining her in bed.
Well, that's a good point because I thought it would be. Good for her and a compliment.
Right. Well, if she looked like she did when she was Daisy Duke.
Right.
But not
young
now.
Kids, do you think young men masturbate to Jessica Simpson?
They used to. I can't
wonder,
imagine
wonder
that
if there's
they're
any
doing
young
it now.
Men in the studio right now that could tell us that.
Now, I've heard stories from friends of John Mayer.
Well, I hope your daughter comes to work with you. You know, next week, do you know
no,
we're having...
first of all, what you said to me about
no.
my daughter
you know
a
what
long
next
time
week
ago,
is?
You're a
gay sick. Daddies bring their girls to work day.
Oh, do they really?
Yeah.
Oh, I'll do that.
Yeah.
Oh, what you said to me about my daughter once, I'll never forget.
What did I say?
We were on this other station in New York, and you were going, you change your daughter? Do you get excited when you change your daughter? I was like, what is wrong with you?
Well,
I have boys. I have boys, so, I would change a diaper, but I was wondering if a man that changes a woman's, a girl's diaper would get excited about that. I was like, I was like wanting to say you're so fucked up, but we're on regular radio and you were laughing.
Just say it now.
Yeah.
He's so fucked up.
And then he has his son on. Hey, son, why don't you look at this wooden penis here? I wish. And then, I feel bad because I never talked to my daddy about big wooden penises.
Well, you know something? We don't get
cool
to spend
daddy.
A lot of time together, so it's great that he's in the studio. And what's the game you bought?
Battlefield.
Garrett, do you know that game?
Came out today. It's supposed to be like the Call of Duty killer kind of
You
thing.
See what a hot Hollywood dad I am? We got that game today, baby.
Hey, Jay, do you think you can get me tickets to the Glee concert?
Oh, my God.
I need to. My daughter and I want to go to the Glee concert.
It's what is that, from the TV show?
Yeah, from the TV show. Do you know anybody?
For TV shows?
Yeah, they do. They have it. So.
Yeah.
Well,
Do you know anybody?
I guess you're not planning a career in radio, huh, Jake?
No.
Not at all.
No.
So that's it.
How does Jake feel about Jessica Simpson? Do you think she's hot or she's
yeah,
fat?
How do you feel about her?
I mean, I don't know. I haven't really seen what she looks like recently.
Oh, you know, she's...
What about medical
she
marijuana?
She looks a little bit like she did before, except now she's a little chubbier.
She looks like somebody's mother.
Well, I'm looking at a picture now. She kind of just... She looks a little healthier, if anything.
Yeah.
But she's too old for you, right?
Well, I don't... How old is she?
30.
Yeah.
How old are you, Jake?
I'm 17.
Oh, my God.
An old lady.
Yeah. 13 years
old. That's an old lady to him.
Oh, God forbid.
An old
of course.
Lady to him, then.
She wants...
Now, let me show you that. Let me show you the 8-foot
like,
wooden penis again.
Miley Cyrus
Selena
or something.
Selena Gomez. Miley Cyrus is trashy. Selena Gomez.
Oh, no. Yeah. Whoa.
Can what I about tell my Jessica
what about,
Simpson
What about iCarly?
What about it?
Yeah, I like iCarly. She's a cute little kid, right?
Do I don't
like
know.
She's like 12.
You know, what about Zach and Cody? Do you watch them?
Zach and Cody?
Yeah.
Are you assuming that I watch Nickelodeon and Cartoon Network in my free time?
I do. And I'm 53.
Yeah.
Oh, all right. Well, I'll tell you what. This is stimulating talk radio here.
Stimulating talk radio.
All right. I'm going to go find this thing that's supposedly in my car on my desk, and it's the Jay Thomas Show, and we'll be right back.
As he grew, he'd say, I'm going to be like you, Dad. You know I'm going to be like you. Cats in the cradle and the silver spoon. Little boy living the man on the moon. When you're coming home, Daddy, don't know when. But we'll be together then. You know we'll have a good time then.
The Jay Thomas Show.
Jay Thomas.
Stars 2.
The Curious. The Extreme. The Fascinated.
The Fascinated.
Jay Thomas.
On Stars 2.
Sirius 108, XM 139. And on the Sirius XM iPhone and BlackBerry app.
CNBC on SiriusXM presents a special Tom Brokaw Reports, Boomers.
When CNBC came to me with the idea of doing a documentary on the baby boomers, I thought it was a perfect fit because I've always been fascinated by their enormous presence in our lives. Join me for the epic story of a generation.
Tom Brokaw Reports, Boomers. Thursday, 9 p.m. East, 6 West on CNBC, Sirius 129.
Fridays at 8 p.m. East.
The Game On guys give you the tips and tricks to bag the girl.
Hey guys, Jordan Harbinger here.
And AJ Harbinger from SiriusXM's Game On and The Art of Charm.
If you guys want to start really kicking butt out there and being fearless, you got to push the envelope and you got to shatter those social boundaries that keep you guys in your comfort zone. A lot of guys have issues touching and showing affection with people they just met, especially in public. And this is a really, really complicated topic. I'm going to tell you how to get started with it here. But if you want more, AJandJordanTalkChicks.com is a place for you.
Okay guys, here's the mission. Go to a crowded area and get as many hugs as possible in a given amount of time. You can even turn it into a contest with your friends to see who can get the most. Now all you've got to do is walk up and say, "You look really friendly, can I give you a hug?" It sounds corny, but it's that easy and it'll help you guys get used to physical escalation.
Quick tip here, when you're approaching people, make sure you're facing them, do not come up from behind. Make sure you guys give them strong eye contact and start talking about 10 feet before they get to you. Otherwise, their momentum is going to be too much to overcome. Alright guys, be sure to catch Game On every Friday at 8 p.m. Eastern on Sirius 108, XM 139.
ArtOfCharm.com
for more ways to live a great life
and get the girl. Only on Stars 2.
Stars 2.
Sirius 108 and XM 139. Covino and Rich on Stars 2.
Hey, it's Covino.
I'm Rich.
Talking about all the things that you want and how to get them. Like women, the job promotion, a good sandwich,
a little respect.
That's what I'm saying.
Also, we talk about the things that you and your friends are talking about.
Sports, music, entertainment, you name it. We talk about it on the Covino and Rich Show. You need to check us out.
Covino and Rich, noon to 3 p.m. East, 9 a.m. to noon West. Covino and Rich, midday. 3 and 1 and XM 139. Stars 2. Thomas.
The Afternoon Drive Show on Stars 2.
Jay Thomas.
Stars 2.
Jay Thomas.
Sirius 108, XM 139. And on the Sirius XM iPhone and BlackBerry app.
My son turned 10 just the other day. He said, "Thanks for the ball, Dad. Come on, let's play. Can you teach me to throw?" I said, "Not today. I got a lot to do." He
I think it's interesting when you listen to a person on the air, you get an image of them, they talk about their family, and then one of their family members comes into the studio, and it's just a normal, you know, I'm just a normal dad, right, Jake? Just a dad.
Normal dad.
Yeah. Normal dad.
Normal dad. Showing his son a
I'm sure when you're changing your 12-year-old daughter, you're just a normal dad.
Yeah, I'm not showing my daughter 12, you know, big wooden cocks.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Look
thank
at this.
You, Jake.
Hey, son, look at this.
Hey,
this
Garrett, that was a good one. Jake said, not yet, okay? He's got it. He's got it.
Yeah. No, he's defending you. He's very good.
Well, we're spending some time together, he and I, right now.
That's nice. Why don't you take a steam afterwards? Hey, Jake, why don't we go in the steam room for a little while?
All right.
Warm in here.
Don't open that on the air. That's making all kinds of people are going to think I'm on fire.
Hold oh, my God. Jay's on fire.
Hold on.
Oh, listen to this. So the other day, we had the big snowstorm, right? So I call.
This. Hold on.
Ah! No! Ah! So I call my parents and I said, are you all set?
Look what you did. Look what you did right there.
What did I do?
I'm listening, Kevin.
Okay, I'm trying to tell a great story about the storm.
Go ahead.
About parenting and
sure.
about older parents.
Sure.
So my parents are, there they are, they're at their house, and it's a big storm. I said, are you all set? My dad goes, yeah, we're all set. We got everything. I said, what about if the electricity goes off? Yeah, I got logs for the fire, but I'll probably light myself on fire.
That's what your dad said?
Yes. Because I thought that was so romantic that if the electric went out, they would go, okay, let's get in front of the
fire.
Do
you and your dad ever change your daughter together?
No, we never did that. No.
You ever lift her legs in the air? You lift her little legs in the air and wipe her pootie?
Oh, God.
No, I've never done that.
I couldn't have touched a daughter. I couldn't have.
Why?
I just couldn't have.
Poo.
Too weird. Weird.
It's poo.
Ah. God.
Yeah. Mm-mm. And sometimes blood.
Oh!
Oh, my God.
Because there's always blood.
Authorities believe a Montesano, Washington man was killed when he accidentally hit a downed power line, okay? And he had to urinate and he peed on the power line.
Mm.
The electricity ran up the pee and killed him.
That's tell you, that will fix your prostate real quick.
Mythbusters.
I didn't know that could happen.
It can't.
Yeah, Mythbusters, let's get them on that.
Hold on a minute.
They did it. They proved it wrong.
Go to Montesano, Washington. This is from the Associated Press. Authorities believe a Washington man was killed when he accidentally urinated on a downed power line after a car crash.
Okay? I'll pee on the third rail every so often when I'm in the subway, you know.
I didn't know if that could happen or not, but they say that the electricity ran up the line.
The pee line.
You've seen it happen, Jay?
I have.
Where?
There's a video of a guy peeing on an electric fence. And there's a smoking hole in his crotch.
Have you seen that, Garrett? The smoking hole in the man's crotch?
Yeah, but that's all trick fake. Photography.
Yeah. It is not fake.
You're going to be fighting Kevin to get to the computer to see that one.
The stream of pee doesn't come out in a steady stream.
Yeah.
Sure it does.
Yeah,
it does
when you're young.
That's not a good stream.
Yeah.
That's not a strong stream.
You know what? This kid's had actually two or three good lines. Okay?
Yeah, he has.
Two or three good lines.
Yeah.
So find out, Garrett, if that's true, because...
We've got penis talk here with me and my son, Jake, talking about all things about our penises. Jake, tell us a little bit about your penis. Well, you ever see anything that, explodes? Tell us that video you saw about that big dick. Yeah, go ahead, Jake. Talk about your penis.
Let's go to Sarah of Charlotte. Hello, Sarah. The show is on. You have a pet problem, Sarah? Can we help you?
Yeah, well, I hope so. I'm trying to get some advice on having surgery for a dog.
What's wrong with his penis?
What's wrong with it?
Does he have a penis problem?
We just had people come on, and the dog... We've had about 10 dog penis calls in a row.
Not one of those.
Thank God. Is it a female?
Yeah, she's a female.
Has she ever had a penis in her vagina?
No. Mm-mm.
Now, what about...
Is it something with her teats?
Do what?
Is it something to do with her teats?
No, she's got a torn ACL in her knee.
So what about her vagina then is dry? Is that what you're trying to say?
No, wait a minute. She has a torn ACL. I hate to say this, but I would put that dog to sleep.
You would?
Yes, ma'am.
Well,
that is going Oh, yeah.
I would first stimulate the dog with a Q-tip in the vagina.
I am feeling the dog signaling me that she wants to go.
Well, I certainly, I'm not getting that.
Come in for the pet communicator, Garrett, by accident? Uh-huh. Yeah. Well, we got rid of that call, didn't we?
Are they still on the air?
Are they? Oh, they love that show.
Take another call.
She just did a live show this weekend at Irving Plaza.
Thousands of people show up.
Thousands of people, all with their pet dogs and cats. God,
and she talks to them.
We got to do a show like that, Jay. You know?
How do 100 dogs and cats coexist together?
You got to get the permits, you
know? Where do they pee and shit?
Yep. Oh. Mitchell has just emailed me. I listen to your show every weekday. I am from Lafayette, Louisiana, yet I have lived in your home of Patterson, Louisiana, and I have good friends there. I hear you grew up. That's true. I did. Anyway, your best partner in the air is this Kevin Meaney guy.
Mm-hmm.
Listen to this one.
Yeah.
He makes your show 5 times better.
Thank you.
5.
Yeah.
How would he have chosen the number 5? That is amazing to me.
Mm-hmm.
Wish he was on more.
Well, I do too.
There, you know what? You can be on as much as you want to.
I do too. You know,
really?
If I could, be on here every day with you, with your son Jake talking about our dicks, it'd be great.
You know what? When your daughter, if ever I meet your daughter, you're fucking done, okay?
You will never meet my daughter.
Oh, yeah, I will.
Ever.
Oh, yeah.
Ever.
You've said stuff in front of my young son, and I'm never going to forgive you for it, Mr. Fucking Funny, okay?
Now you know what?
Challenge is on.
Hey, watch
because
this. Daddy's going to say fuck. Watch this. Hey.
No, I am going to meet your daughter, and you know what I'm going to say to her?
Daddy's
going to
say fuck right now, really.
How's that little teen discharge doing down there? Huh, sweetie?
Oh my God.
Oh, you betcha.
Oh.
You do not talk like that in front of my son.
Oh.
You homosexual. We'll be right back.
Oh, God.
We'll be right back.
Oh. That'd be good if we had a break to go.
We don't have a break? So we have to stay here.
That's successful the show is.
Stretch.
Hey,
stretch.
Son.
You know what?
Son, sorry.
Are you kidding?
We used it all our commercials already, son.
Let's go to Vince in California. The phone calls never stop. I could talk all night.
We have one phone call.
Kevin Meaney.
What's
going on?
Hey.
Yeah. I got a great sex story you've got to hear that happened to me on Thursday.
Okay.
My son is here, Vince.
Tell us.
All right. Well, I met this chick, and she wanted to go to see the RuPaul drag show at the local gay bar, so we went there.
Mm-hmm.
It was actually pretty cool. Jay, you're right about gay bars, about people leaving in your own and stuff. Well, anyway, she gets all liquored up, and I'm not drinking because I'm driving her home.
Can you move your mouth back from the phone a little bit? You know, you're doing one of these.
All right. How about now?
Go ahead.
Yeah, that's
and
great.
Relax, okay? Anyway, quit being so excited.
Yeah. I'm sorry. Anyway, she's driving me. I'm driving her home, and she decides to give me roadhead, and I can't get home fast enough. She's like, "Before we go, take me over to get something to eat." So I take her to the parking lot, and she goes, "Do you want to fuck me right now?" And I said, "Yes, please."
My son is here. Get him off the thing. Get him off.
No, go ahead.
Get him off the thing.
Did you cut him off? So you had sex with her in the car?
No, this is terrible. No, stop it.
That's a natural thing.
My son. No,
it's natural.
No, hang up,
if you're
Garrett.
Then
Garrett,
you have to do your show.
Hang up on this guy. Are you nuts?
The buttons broke.
What are you talking about? The kids.
No, stop it. Stop it.
Oh, you're such a baby.
No. My son is here. My son. Jesus, this show's taking forever to end.
Hey, let's take a homosexual caller. We want some homosexual sex.
Garrett, I'm telling you now to hang that phone up on this guy. Are you nuts?
Well, he didn't know that he was going to talk
like
that.
Yes, he did. Are you people crazy? My son is here.
Let's talk to Father O'Reilly.
I could put a pet psychic call on, right?
Yes, yeah, okay. Go right ahead.
Go ahead.
Pet psychic.
Go.
Oh, yes, we love our pets. Yes, we have a new caller.
Let me tell you something, Kevin. That poodle was in real trouble. I'm glad we're able to save it.
Well,
hi. What is your name, please?
Hello?
Hello? Pet psychics? Hello?
Hello? Pet psychics?
Pet psychics?
Hello?
Hello?
Yes.
Hello? Yes, can yes. we help you?
We take care of pets that need help. Hello.
Hello.
Yes. What is your pet? What kind of pet is it? What is it?
It's a Labradoodle.
It's a Labradoodle. Oh. Now, what
does
size?
That mean that the Labrador put its penis in a poodle?
Poodle? Yes. Yes.
Exactly.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Now, how big is your Labradoodle's penis? We'd like to know.
She hung up.
She did? Why would she hang up?
More pet psychic calls coming in.
Hello, we're the pet psychics. Hello. Hello, we're the pet psychics. Hello, we love
what
to
sort
work
of animal
pets.
Are you calling about, please?
A dog.
A dog. How big is your dog's penis? Hello? Hello?
Well, they every time up. You ask that, they're going to hang up. You're an idiot. You're the worst crank caller
guy
in the world.
Let's do it again. Let's get another pet psychic. Right, hello, pet psychic. Hello. Hello, pet psychics.
I was just calling.
Yes.
To speak with Sonia Fitzpatrick?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we'd like to take care of your pets. What's wrong
How
with your
deep
pet?
Is your cat's vagina?
Yes. Hello?
Have you ever put a measuring tape inside of it?
Have you ever put a measuring tape inside your cat's vagina?
Listen, lady, you called up here. What's wrong with the dog or the cat? Come on.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes, go ahead, please.
Don't quit saying hello. What's wrong with the damn animal?
How big is the animal's penis?
Get an inside look at the preparations, the pressure, and the prestige of winning gold. Sirius XM host and Olympic champion Johnny Mosley takes you behind the scenes of the 2010 Winter Olympics on a special presentation of The Mosley Method.
Johnny Mosley, off action, coming from the Vancouver Olympics. This place is going off. What a games.
Tomorrow night, 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 Pacific.
The streets are just insane.
Only on Sirius 28 Faction.
Fridays at 8 p.m. East.
The Game On guys give you the tips and tricks to bag the girl.
Hey guys, Jordan Harbinger here.
And AJ Harbinger from SiriusXM's Game On and The Art of Charm.
If you guys want to start really kicking butt out there and being fearless, you gotta push the envelope and you gotta shatter those social boundaries that keep you guys in your comfort zone. A lot of guys have issues touching and showing affection with people they just met, especially in public. And this is a really, really complicated topic. I'm gonna tell you how to get started with it here, but if you want more, AJandJordanTalkChicks.com is a place for you.
Okay guys, here's the mission. Go to a crowded area and get as many hugs as possible in a given amount of time. You can even turn it into a contest with your friends to see who can get the most. Now all you've got to do is walk up and say, "You look really friendly, can I give you a hug?" It sounds corny, but it's that easy and it'll help you guys get used to physical escalation.
Quick tip here, when you're approaching people, make sure you're facing them, do not come up from behind. Make sure you guys give them strong eye contact and start talking about 10 feet before they get to you. Otherwise, their momentum is going to be too much to overcome. Alright guys, be sure to catch Game On every Friday at 8 p.m. Eastern on Sirius 108 XM 139.